Welcome to this lecture, Applications of Mechatronic System. In our previous lecture, we discussed about the basic elements of mechatronic system. And in this lecture, we are going to discuss some few applications of the mechatronic system. There are so many applications when it comes to mechatronic system. Here, we are going to discuss one applications with respect to measuring system. That is digital liquid level measuring system, and one applications on open loop system, that is the clothes dryer. So this is an open loop system, and one application with respect to closed loop system, and that is the room heater. That is what we are going to discuss in this lecture. Digital liquid level measuring system. The function of this system is to measure the level of liquid in a tank. Okay, and for that we are using a sensor, that is the float with potentiometer. The float senses the level of liquid and converts the level into a corresponding electrical signal, and that electrical signal should be processed. So for that we are using signal processor. That means the electrical signal can be amplified or it can be converted into a corresponding digital signal. Okay. So once the signal is processed, it should be communicated to the user. Okay, and for that we are using LED or LCD as a display devices. So that is how the system operates. Cloths dryer. Cloths dryer is used to dry the wet cloths, and this is the block diagram of the cloths dryer. And in this block diagram, the desired time is set by the user with the help of timer. This timer controls or operates the heating element, and this heating element produces the heat required to dry the wet cloths. Okay, and this is how the system operates, and for this operation the electrical energy is needed, and that is why it is placed here. Okay, so here the actual dryness depends upon the time set by the user. Okay, since it is an open loop system, it doesn't have any feedback. Okay. And we can make this open loop system as a closed loop system. How? We can place a sensor here, and we can sense the actual dryness of the cloths, and we can give the feedback to the controller, that is the timer, so that the timer operates the heating element based on the actual dryness. Okay, so that is also possible, but here we are going to use only for as a open loop system. And for closed loop system, we are going to see the room heater as a closed loop system. Okay, room heater. The room heater is used to keep the room warmer. Okay, and this is the block diagram of the room heater, and in this block diagram the input is the required temperature set by the user, and this input is given to the comparison element. The comparison element is used to compare two signals. Okay, one signal is from the input and another signal is from the thermostat. The thermostat is a sensor that senses the actual room temperature and converts to the corresponding electrical signal. So now the comparison element compares these two signals, and if there is any difference, then it generates an error signal and it gives to the switch. The function of the switch is to switch on or switch off the heating coil. The heating coil produces the heat when it is switched on by the switch. Okay, so this is the operation of each and every block. Let us assume an example. The required temperature may be 30 degrees Celsius. Okay, that is given as input to the comparison element. But the actual room temperature, let's say, is 25 degrees Celsius. Okay, that is sensed by the thermostat and it is given to the comparison element. Okay, so the required temperature is 35 degrees Celsius, the actual temperature is 25 degrees Celsius. So therefore the comparison element compares the two signal and it generates the error. Okay, so now the switch will operate the heating coil. Okay, so now the heating coil is switched on by the switch, so that the temperature is now starts to increase from 25 degrees Celsius. Okay, so it may rise to 25, 26, 27, Okay, when it reaches 30 degrees Celsius, the thermostat senses the temperature and it gives to the comparison element. And now at 30 degrees Celsius, both the input as well as the thermostat output will be same. Okay, when it is same, there will not be any error signal and the switch switches off the heating coil. Okay, likewise the system operates. So this is a closed loop system because the output is feedback into the input. Okay, thank you.